Hey, Michael Church, Crawl Space Ninja, and we got another question from Wade in Virginia, and he has a sunroom that does not have a crawl space around it, and he's wanting to know the best way to insulate it. Stay tuned. Okay, so we're gonna put a picture up that Wade sent in of his sunroom, but basically you can see that there's some plywood that they put underneath in order to block wind and different things and critters from getting up into the sunroom. And from the way he's describing it, is there, I guess, is some bat insulation, probably some fiberglass insulation between the plywood and the subfloor of the sunroom. So how would you insulate something like that? Well, you've got to be really careful. In Virginia, the average humidity in January is between 61 and 68%. So they're dealing with a humidity problem all the time. So what you need to do is, if you're going to insulate underneath an area that is open to the outside humidity, you might want to think about blocking that area off and drying the wood before you put any kind of insulation. It's going to be a bit of a pain to do that, but you can maybe staple up some plastic around the entire space to create what we would call a containment area. Put in a dehumidifier after you remove that plywood and bat insulation that's already up in there. So you get the plywood down, remove the insulation, create a containment, put a dehumidifier in there, get you a wood moisture meter, which I'll put down a link below so you can get you a wood moisture meter. You check the wood moisture level, get it below, say, 9 to 12%, somewhere around in there. Then you can take a good foam board. Now, we would use our termite-resistant foam board, obviously, but you cut it to fit between the floor joists, okay? And you shove that up in there, and then you could spray foam the exposed wood if you wanted to and lock that foam board into place, or you could just spray foam the edges of the foam board to lock it into place and make sure you're air sealing that foam board up against the subfloor. If you have enough room, it sounded like you had a double rim joist, so if you had enough room, you could maybe even do two layers of foam board, because the foam board is only 2 to 2.25 inches thick. All right, then after all of that, I would still take some pressure treated plywood and cover all of that back up, and then air seal that plywood with a good caulk, probably a silicone caulk or something like that, maybe a 25-year caulk, and then paint the plywood if it's a paintable grade plywood, which it should be. That way you're protecting that plywood from moisture and water exposure. You've got the plywood caulked, you've got the insulation air sealed, and you've also got that thermal barrier underneath the sunroom. Sounds like a pretty big project, but make sure you just dry out all that wood before you add any insulation up in there. One other thing Wade was asking is, apparently he has about 1,000 square foot crawl space, and he was wanting to know, does he need a dehumidifier? Wade, nobody wants to buy a dehumidifier. Nobody. Okay, so the short answer is, guess what? Yes. Because as I mentioned before, Virginia humidity in January typically is between 61 and 68%, and obviously it's going to be higher in the summer and in the fall months. So you're probably going to need a good dehumidifier in that crawl space in order to control humidity and make sure that wood does not get saturated with water. My name is Michael Church with Crawl Space Ninja. We hope you make it a happy and blessed day, and we'll see you later.